Hi, and in today's tutorial, I'm going to show you a few fun text effects in Photoshop that you can manipulate and customize. This particular one is how to make text look like a slight plastic effect, but you can change the colors and designs to suit your needs. So I've just got a background in here, just two layers here. These are solid fill colors. So if you go to the bottom here and click, you can see I've got a solid color here. I've got two of those layers, but on this layer here, or this layer mask here, I've just applied a circular gradient. Go to this gradient tool here, make sure it's on the circle effect here, and just click and drag out that gradient. So to add your text, just go to text or the T icon here, and then I'm just going to click and insert my text. I'm going to click the checkbox here at the top. So I'm going to increase the size and look of this text, and the quickest and easiest way to do that is to transform it. Go to Edit, Free Transform, or Command or Control T, and then you can pull the sides out, you can pull it down, out and stretch it to get the look that you want. And we'll just pop that roughly in the middle and click OK. To change the color, just simply click on this box up here, and then you can move around your color wheel using the slider to choose your selected color. So I'm going to go back to red and maybe choose this color and click OK. So to create some effects on this text, you need to go over to this text layer and simply double click on the gray area, and this layer styles panel will appear. So if you check bevel emboss, you can see immediately we have an effect, but if we click on the actual layer itself, we've got a number of customization options. So we can change the inner bevel to emboss or pillow emboss or stroke emboss. And again, you can play around with all of these different options. I'm going to go with inner bevel. I'm going to stay with smooth. My depth is at 168, but of course, if you move this slider, you can see what effect this has on your text. Size, again, you can adjust the size of this effect, and obviously soften as well here to make it look a little bit more rounded. I'm going to keep that at 16, maybe increase the size probably to about 40. The angle here, you see this little dot here. So you can move this around, and this allows you to adjust where the light is coming from. And you can see over here on the right where the light would be pointing from to affect your text. You can adjust the contour. All of these have very different design effects. I'm going to stick with this normal gloss contour here. I'm going to stick with screen. You can reduce or increase the opacity of this effect as well. If you want more of a highlight and a contrast to it, you can increase that opacity. I'm going to keep it to about here. And then again, you can increase or decrease that shadow effect as well. The other effect I'm going to use is inner shadow. So if you click on that one, double click on the layer itself, and then you can adjust all these different options. I've kept this to normal at the top, but if we just zoom in, if I switch this on and off, you can see the effect that this is having, and it's just giving it an additional highlight on that right hand side. You can once again adjust the light here, just move that down or up, completely your choice. Again, you can adjust all these sliders. This will give you more of a highlight, less of a highlight, and this will give you a harder line to your highlight. And the size, again, how much distance it will cover. See, if we go all the way down to size there, it's a very sharp line. And then if we move that up, you can see it's a little bit softer. So you can play around with all of these. And again, you can go down to your contour and decide on the look that you want. I'm just going to keep it at the normal one here and then just click OK. Let's make this a little bit bigger. If you want to keep your text exactly the same ratio, then just hold down your shift key. And if you want to make sure it's all perfectly lined up, then just press Command or Control A. And you can see I've now got a dotted line all the way around the outside of my image. And make sure I'm on the text layer here. press my V key or click on this move tool here. And across the top, we've got this align to center tool and align to middle tool. Once you're done, press Command or Control D to deselect. And there you have your text in the middle of your image. If you want to go back and adjust any of these, just double click on the one that you want to adjust, and then you can go right back in and adjust that text. Once you've found exactly what you want, great thing about this is that you can now go in and change the font if you want to. So I'm just going to reduce the size of my image, and then you can simply go back to text, and then simply go back to text, click on the T here. You can click on this drop down, and then you can simply scroll through and you can see all the different fonts that you can select and how they will look with that text effect. There are so many to choose from, and they really can change the whole look of your text. So I hope that's helped you today. If it has, please like and subscribe, and have a great day.